working in a coal mine, going down, 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 working in a coal mine, whoop, about to step down, working in a coal mine.
Greetings, everyone. This is David Fulmer back with Fiction Shop. And in this segment, we're going to cover three questions about dialogue. Now, if you looked at the dialogue lesson that I did, I explained that dialogue is super important because it does so much lifting in a narrative. It conveys information that you would have to otherwise use exposition, which we don't want to do, going, you know, explaining things on and on. Those things, that information can be explained in the course of a dialogue. It tells you who a character is by the way they speak, you know, what their background is, where they come from, all kinds of interesting things about who that character is. And it also conveys emotion. Like, you know what a character is thinking and feeling by way of dialogue. So it does all that, and we want to get it right. So let's get into these three questions. Question number one. How do we avoid having characters sound alike? Well, this is a common problem that you're writing and you're doing dialogue, and when you go back and read it, you realize that it sounds like the same person is talking, just, you know, from a different point of view. So how do you do that? Okay, well, to begin, if you've done the character development, you will know the differences between your characters, and that will affect the way they speak. That is who they are and the way they talk. And so you will find that you have different rhythms, different uses of certain words. Some people will use very simple words. Other people will use other longer, more complicated 50-cent words, as it was, just for whatever reason. But think about the best way I can explain this to you is that you're going to imagine this dialogue. And if you're not hearing it, if you're not hearing the dialogue, then you need to go back and do some more work so that you really hear the dialogue in your head. Now, I've been asked, this is a side question, do you read your dialogue aloud? And I do not, but I know people that do, and they feel it works for them. But I can hear the dialogue in my head of my characters. So what I'm doing then is I am basically taking down what those characters say and the way that they say it. So that's the key to getting characters that sound differently. There are different characters, they come from different places, they have different personalities, and they're going to speak differently. But in order to get that, you're going to need to do that homework and understand their background, okay? Can you hear it raining? It's really coming down here. By the way, it's a late morning in Atlanta on July, 29th, I believe? And yep, here comes the rain. Okay, question number two. How do we use characters' names in dialogue? Okay, well, this is something that comes up a lot, and it is a mistake that a lot of writers make, and it's not corrected. And, you know, I've even read this in books by some, you know, pretty popular authors and best-selling authors. That doesn't make it work any better. So think about this. If you and I were having a discussion, back and forth, a dialogue, how many times do you think that I would mention your name? What, one, two, and the whole dialogue? That's how our normal dialogues work and how your dialogue should work on the page. There's no reason for you to be saying, for your characters to be saying the other character's name over and over again. But again, I see it all the time. Okay? So it's like, let's say, well, Howard, how are you feeling? Howard, I don't know what the answer is to that, Howard, but I'll find out, Howard. Really, I mean, it might not be quite that ridiculous, but I've seen some that were just so overdone with the use of names that they, it just stopped me. It was so curious and weird, because I know in real life, that doesn't happen. Now, I want to say that years ago, there was someone on one of the shows, one of the do-it-yourself shows, that, and I think it was because of nerves, that this guy would repeat the character's name, like, with every sentence. Like, okay, well, we're going to put the drywall up here, George, but I want to tell you one more thing, George. Okay, that is completely unnatural. You don't need to do it. So there is one exception, and that brings us to question number three. How do you keep track in dialogue of multiple characters? The answer to that is, this is a place where you may need to use names a lot more often. Okay, so what you need to do is make sure that your readers understand who is speaking. Okay, now as we discussed this before, yes, you can use names, but I just told you, you don't want to overdo that, and plus it wouldn't be natural. I mean, if you were talking to two people, you wouldn't have to, you know, say their names as you went from person to person. But your reader does need to know who they are. So, again, here's something that you can do. You can identify a character by their, by their profession. You know, the detective said, the policeman said, okay, the teacher said. You can identify them by their age. You can say the older woman said, or any number of things that describes that person without being something like stereotypical, and certainly nothing insulting like the idiot said. And again, here's an opportunity to use your body language, to use your stage business, which we talked about in the dialogue lesson. And that way make clear who is talking or who is being spoken to. Okay? Just do it very carefully. Come back to it with your writer's mind, editor's mind, right? You write it down, and then you come back to it as if you were editing a stranger. How does this work? Is it confusing? Now remember, it's not going to be confusing to you, the writer of this narrative, but it could be to confusing to your reader, so that's why you have to address it as if you were a stranger, as if a stranger was reading it, okay? So, again, dialogue is so critically important to carrying your narrative, and it's just so much more interesting, for instance, than exposition, and there will be instances where you will you need exposition. But again, you can do that. You can convey information with dialogue. It's actually the best way to convey it. It's certainly the most interesting and intriguing for your readers. Okay? So, next segment coming up, next segment will be three questions about scene structure, okay? And that's always really interesting because the scene, which sometimes will be pretty much simply a dialogue, is your basic component of a narrative, is the scene. And so you want to get that right. So I'll come back with three questions that I get a lot about scene structure, okay? Reach out with whatever other questions you have at the website, www.davidfulmer.com. Stay healthy. If you're feeling a little off, get better. And let's all move onward, okay? If you can hear the rain, it's getting to me. I think I need to go take a nap. All right, see you next time.